Hello, Kafia. Hi, good afternoon. How are you?
Hi, very good, thanks, Mike. How are you?
Do you know what? It's that kind of Friday feeling, isn't it? It's Kafia. I'm just, first of all, really want to thank you for joining us. A very special guest. I know how busy a time it is for you and how busy a time it is for War Child. Would you introduce yourself and your role at War Child, please?
Yep, certainly. My name is Kafia Omar. I'm the Policy and Advocacy Advisor with War Child UK. So I sit within the broader programs and advocacy department.
So folk will be very familiar with War Child, but maybe you could just elaborate on what advocacy and policy means and what that means in real terms for folk.
Sure. So as people might know, War Child is, obviously a charity, and it delivers services such as education, livelihood, psychosocial support. And a lot of that work's done directly from our programs teams. I work on the advocacy side, which is more of an indirect way of influencing. So campaigning for change, trying to create and push for changes in policy that will help us achieve our work more directly as well.
So would you be having to kind of lobby and negotiate with legislators and influencers that way? Is that how it works, Kafia?
Yes, exactly. So being based in the UK, we're doing a lot of work with the UK government to try and get them to prioritise the issue of children and armed conflict, as well as supporting our teams in country to do national and regional advocacy as well.
Course, so this will be important work. And maybe if you just wanted to elaborate a little bit further on those type of policies that you're influencing and making change in for our audience would be great, Kafia.
Yeah, of course. As I mentioned, I mean, for the UK, we believe the UK's already got a lot of strong policies in place, and is doing a lot to protect children's rights, but we think there's more that can be done. We've been, over the last few years, producing research which assesses how the UK is doing in terms of that agenda and providing recommendations. And that's really, being fed into by our country teams. So certain areas that we're pushing for example, is a strategy that is dedicated to the issue of children and armed conflict. So it's also just easier for us to be able to engage with the government on those issues and work together more collaboratively.
It must be tremendously fulfilling when you see an idea that gets recommended to policy, then baked into law, and then implemented on the ground, and you see it going fulfilled that way. So, Kafia, it's War Child is also known to lots of folk because your cultural resonance and your music, and we've had fun with our guests in this show naming three songs that you like, and we're gonna our guests say a song that's very important, and we play 90 seconds of the song and then we come back. So this is like Kafia's jukebox, as it were. So what is the first song you'd like to put forward, Kafia, and why is it important to you?
Sure. Actually, the first one I'll put forward is one that I've been listening to quite recently, quite a lot. It's by Mika and it's called El Madi. I've been trying to learn French actually to help me with not just work, but it's also just useful to know another language. And was one of the homeworks I got set to try and find a song and just learn it in French and then translate it into English. But it's been stuck in my head for the past few weeks. So.
Fantastic. Well, I just gotta say, cue song, and I'll see you in 90 seconds.
Chanson contente, pas une chanson déprimante, une chanson que tout le monde aime. Elle me dit, tu deviendras milliardaire, t'auras de quoi être fier, ne finis pas comme ton père. Elle me dit, ne t'enferme pas dans ta chambre, vas-y, secoue-toi et tant, dis-moi c'est quoi ton problème.
What a fantastic song! Now it sounds very, very cheerful, Kathy, but I don't think it's a cheer. What is that song all about?
So it's actually a man who's talking about, you know, his life regrets and constantly being given advice by his parents to do something and how he could have, you know, done things a lot better. But he's just kind of, you know, embracing himself and saying, you know, he wants to do what he wants to do. So,
fantastic.
Yeah, it relates to his mom.
Our fellow guest, Abed, was introducing Bashir, one of the artists that he represents in the Palestinian Music Expo. And I think it was Bashir, but the song was, you know, his parents constantly asking the young man why he wasn't married yet.
That's super.
So Kafia, we've touched on your work as a policy advisor and your divorce and war child. And I'd love to get a story to kind of the woman behind the role, you know, what attracted you to work in the charity sector and what attracted your war child, and maybe share your own personal journey with your career with our audience would be great.
Yeah, of course. So I studied law. That was my I've got a legal background, and I've always been, you know, very passionate about policy, justice, human rights issues. And I think once I was in my degree, that's when I kind of realized I really wanted to pursue human rights, and particularly international human rights. And that might stem from my own background and my family being from Somalia. So I'd say over the last nearly 10 years, I've just been working for human rights charity on a different, you know, wide range of issues, but that's kind of been the core. And I actually, just before joining War Child, I recently moved back from Uganda, where I was based for 6 years, and I was working on refugee issues there, mainly with the Sudanese and Somali communities. And for me, I had, you know, the opportunity, I was missing, you know, being back in the UK and wanted to come back. And saw an opportunity with War Child, and I've been following their work for years, and I'm incredibly passionate about children's rights. So,
what an inspirational woman you are, Kafia. So you're Somali folks, then you've worked and lived in Uganda. I mean, I hope the ones in all the, you know, areas that are conflict zones or comes with refugees are dangerous areas too. You know, one would imagine on the face of things too. And so, you know, taking it on the ground experience, and how has that helped you with your perspective on lobbying politicians or the lobbying of setting policy? Is it able to join those dots a bit better now? Or?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think it was really important to, you know, be based in a country where I was working on those issues, just to have a, you know, a broader understanding and to be able to work very closely with those who are also working on those issues. And then now I would say, you know, being back in the UK, because I'm working on the policy front and directly with the UK, it's, that work is great in terms of, you know, having that direct engagement. But I do think my past experiences and, you know, ways of working with civil society, different issues and carrying out research have also been really beneficial for this role.
What an inspiring woman. Parents must be ever so proud of you too, just everything you've achieved and studying law, and you're brilliant. So we're kind of at the midpoint now. We're going to pick the second song, Kafia. So what would be the second song in our Kafia's jukebox, and why?
Sure. I think it might be a continuation of the theme of the first song. So I'll go for Little Richard's Tutti Frutti, which is also a very upbeat song, and I love listening to quite a lot.
And why Little Richard?
So in my spare time, I dance jive, and it's my go-to song for that. And I think just immediately gives you that endorphin release and just a good old classic.
Get out of town, you dance jive. Well, I've got very, very dear friends of mine who are rockabillies and do jive and strolling and all that kind of good stuff. So it's wonderful to meet someone that's into that too. And I was talking to a colleague about that, the whole scene this morning. So it doesn't get better. You've got me with Little Richard. Little Richard, Tutti Frutti, let's take it away.
Okay, you want another, you get it. And you're going to meet the winners of the Harvest Moon Contest, Jimmy and Jovita dancing to Little Richard and Tutti Frutti. She's the gal that
what you do to me, do the food.
Amazing, Kafia, one of my all-time favorites, and Little Richard still broke down so many barriers on and gender, sex, race, music, just amazing, inspiring. Brilliant, put a big smile on my face. So Kafia, if now I'd like to turn maybe, if you maybe just for audience, highlight one of the projects that War Child are involved in currently, maybe showing a little bit of a spotlight on that, and maybe sharing too with our audience how they may be able to help or get involved or to raise awareness. So there's a particular project you want to share with us in a bit more detail, what would it be?
Sure. So obviously, you know, we've got a number of country programs. It's really hard to choose just one, but I think I've been working quite closely more recently with the Afghanistan team, and they are doing a lot of work with unaccompanied minors and children who, you know, have been forced because of the situation that they're in, and their families not being able to have enough resources, have been forced to flee the border and try and secure work to be able to support their families. So our team and colleagues there have been helping in terms of making sure when those children are back, you know, unifying with their families and trying to really fight against some of those push factors that force them to go across the border in the first place. And that's involved, you know, getting children back into education, helping them, you know, learn new skills to be able to secure work and provide livelihood support to their families as well.
So you've War Child colleagues actually on the ground in the field, you know, so implementing the ideas you guys have here on the ground, what resources they need. When folk donate money, you're able to fulfill those resources and those colleagues on the ground doing that work.
Yes, yeah. So our colleagues have a project which is particularly working with this particular vulnerable group of children.
And if you guys weren't doing it, this wouldn't be happening.
Yeah, so War Child's only one of the BFU organisations to be able to do that work, yeah.
Wow. And how can people find out more about this particular initiative, and how can people help and either by raising awareness or donating money?
So we've got, on our website, we've got a lot of policy materials there, information on each of our projects, the countries that we work in. And yes, it would be great for any supporter who sees the work that we're doing and would like to contribute that to donate to the organization. That's just one of the many different initiatives that they could support, which War Child's currently working on.
So, Kafia, time's not on our side. We're coming near the end straight. It's amazing we think for 20 odd minutes, so just time flies by. But I just want to ask you, before we go to your last song choice, I would just maybe ask you if there's one thing you wanted to highlight either about your career, your work, if someone wanted to follow your career path and work in like you got stuff in law and in policy making with War Child, or if a particular project, a particular thing you wanted to highlight for the audience, what would it be?
I think for anyone who wants to, you know, get into human rights and is thinking about what to do, I would definitely recommend trying to get an internship with as many organizations as you possibly can. I was very passionate about human rights, but there's so many different parts that come under it. And I think for me, what helped is, you know, working for different organizations and then kind of narrowing down the exact scope of what I wanted to do. And I think it's just a great way to be able to, you know, develop that experience, build skills, and organizations really do need that help. So it's, yeah, one way that people really get into this.
Inspiring woman, Kafia, an absolute pleasure to meet with you today and have a chat. Maybe you can come back and give us a progress update. Maybe next year will be fabulous. So it's the third choice of song, Kafia. What are you going to play us out on and why?
Sure. So I'll go back in time for this one as well. And I will go for Hanson's Mbop, because I think that's my earliest memory of a song. And
Hanson, yes.
And the 90s were the best. So
and a really great pop song. So Hanson Mbop, fantastic. Kafia, thank you ever so much. The very best of luck with all your projects. The very best of every success for the summer and beyond. And thank you very much for spending time with us, and I hope to speak to you again soon.
Thank you so much.
Hanson.
Yeah.
Thanks. Bye.
Take care. Bye.